Welcome to Data Bit Technologies. I am Shah, and this is part 6 of SQL Server video series. In this session, we'll understand what check constraint is and when do we use it. Check constraint is used to limit the range of the values that can be entered for a specific column. Let's understand this with an example. I have this table called person, which has got this age column. In reality, age of your person cannot be negative. And along the same times, it's impractical for a human being to be alive after 150 years. So the age column should taking values between 0 and 150. But if you look at the data type of this age column, it's an integer. By the way, if you want to find out the data type of any column in SQL Server, there are several ways. One of the easiest ways is to expand the tables folder within the database, and you go to that specific table and expand the columns folder, and you can see that the age column is of type integer and it allows nulls. This is one way. Another quick way to find out the information about the columns that are present inside the table is highlight the table and press Alt F1. So that should bring up the columns and their respective data types as well. So if you look at the age data type, it is of type integer. Since age is integer data type, it can allow any valid integer. For example, let's try to insert a row into this table. So insert into person. Let's say I want to insert ID of 4 and the name of the person may be Sarah. And email s@s.com. And maybe gender ID, as she is a female, let's say 2. And age. Now look at this. Since age is of type integer, I can enter something like 970. If I try to execute this query, the rule will be happily accepted into the table. So for the age column, I'm able to enter an invalid age. So is it possible to prevent numbers like this being entered? All I want to allow with this column is a number between 0 and 150. If anybody tries to enter a number outside of that range, I want to throw an error. Is that possible? Absolutely, using the check constraint of SQL Server. It checks the values while you enter them, and then if it falls outside the train, it throws an error. So how do we add a check constraint? Like any other constraint, check constraint can be added to SQL Server in two ways. One is graphically using the designer, and the other one is obviously using a query. Now first let's see how to do that graphically using the designer. You can go on to the constraints folder in SQL Server Management Studio. Under the table folder, I want to do it for person table. So expand that person table. There you should see a constraints folder. Right click on that. And select new constraint. So this should bring up check constraints window, where we can basically add the constraint information. Now remember, a constraint is just a Boolean expression which returns a true or a false. Now what's our aim? Our aim is that the age column shouldn't be allowing a number less than or greater than 150. So how do we do that? You add that expression here. And whatever expression that you enter here should be a Boolean expression. It should return a true or a false. If it returns true, then the value will be allowed to be entered. If it returns false, then it doesn't allow the value. So what we want to do is? The age should be greater than 0. An age should be less than 150. So anybody is supplying a value for this age column, it has to be within that range. It has to be greater than 0 less than 150. Click OK. And another thing that we have to do is give it a meaningful name. The common convention is that for a check constraint, we use CK prefix. CK underscore the name of the table on which we want to create that constraint, and for the column to which we want to create that constraint. In this case, it's the age column, and then you have another option here, check existing data on creation. Okay, so what does this mean? If there is already invalid data which doesn't fall into this criteria, this constraint will fail, it will not succeed in getting created. So it checks the existing data, you can turn this off or alternatively you can delete that bad data. Okay, let's close that, but T when I try to save it that's we get an error. So unable to add this constraint. Okay, so what we will do first is, we will go ahead and delete that invalid row. So which is that invalid row, the record with ID 4. So let's delete that from that table. So delete from person where ID is equal to 4. So we deleted that invalid row. Now all of the rows are valid for us. So now let's try to save this, and it gets saved. Now let's try to execute this query. And see what's going to happen. So when I try to execute this query, look at that, the check constraint, this kicking in. It's telling that the insert statement conflicted with the check constraint CK underscore person underscore age, the constraint that we have just created. On the other hand, if I supply a valid age, maybe 10 years. And if I try to execute this query, it happily gets inserted. So if we select all the rows from the table, you should see that Sarah has got the age of 10 right now. Okay, now let's do one more test. Let's say we are inserting another Sarah with ID 5. And let's say here instead of passing a value for age. Now remember, age column is a nullable column. Which means, you don't have to supply a value for that. You can just pass null. Okay, so if I pass null, what is going to happen to that Boolean expression that we have written? Okay, now if you remember, the Boolean expression is age should be greater than 0 and at the same time it should be less than 150. Now is null greater than 0 or less than 150? You know this is an unknown value. You know the Boolean expression returns an unknown result. In this case, the constraint passes and allows null to be inserted. So if we run this query, will be executed. Why? Because the Boolean expression doesn't return false. It just returns unknown, because you cannot compare null with anything. So it doesn't return false. That's why it allows nulls to be inserted. So you can add nulls and you can add any valid values that fall within 0 and 150. Okay, so how do we drop a constraint? Now you know that. We have added this constraint using the designer. So obviously if we expand this folder, you should see that constraint there. So how do we delete this constraint or drop this constraint? Again, you can do that graphically, or you can use a command. To do it graphically, you just right-click on that and delete. And if you want to use a command, a SQL Server query, it is just like dropping any other constraint. So obviously, if you want to drop this constraint, it's like you're altering the table, because the constraint is for the table. So we have to tell. We are going to alter the table. So alter. Table. Which table is that? Person. And how are you going to alter this table? I'm going to drop one of the existing constraints. In this case, the check constraint that we have created. Let's refresh this. And we should see that check constraint there. Okay, so I want to drop this constraint. So let's copy that constraint name. So alter, table, person, drop. What do I want to drop? I want to drop a constraint, and then specify the name of the constraint. So you press F5 command, completed successfully. Let's refresh the folder. And the constraints shouldn't be there anymore. Okay, now let's go ahead and see how to add a constraint using SQL query. Now if you look at the presentation, it's very simple. The general formula for adding a check constraint. Not only check constraint, any constraint for that matter. Okay, so alter, table, table name, add constraint, the name of the constraint. So here we are adding a check constraint. So we use this check keyword, and then a Boolean expression. If you remember, while we are doing it graphically, we did it in that Boolean expression window. But here we have to do that within this parenthesis. Okay, so let's see how to do that. So alter, table, table name, and what we want to do we want to add? A constraint. So add constraint, and then you have to give the constraint a meaningful name. So check constraints. By default we'll have a CK prefix underscore the table for which we are adding this constraint. In this case it's going to be person. And for which column it's going to be? For age column. And then what type of constraint are we going to add? Check constraint. And within the parentheses we have to specify the Boolean expression. What should be our Boolean expression? We don't want to allow values for age less than 0 or greater than 150. Okay, so age should be greater than 0 and age should be less than 150. That's it. So I press F5. Command completed successfully. Refreshed the constraints folder. And you should see the constraint once again. And if we try to add any value, something like maybe 950 years. Press F5. It should give an error. Alright, so that's how we do that. And remember, if this Boolean expression returns true, the check constraint allows the value, otherwise it doesn't, since it is a nullable column. It's possible to pass a null value for this column when we are inserting a row. So when you pass a null for this age column, the Boolean expression evaluates to unknown and allows that null value. So it's possible for you to insert nulls, because why the Boolean expression that's involved there returns an unknown result. Okay, so when will I check constraint prevent a value from being entered whenever the Boolean expression returns false? Okay, and to drop a constraint. We have seen. We use this alter, table, and drop constraint, the name of the constraint. That's all for today. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Having success in your work.